One of my favorite things to eat is thin slices of salt beef that's hot and succulent and full of flavor. And I'm gonna give you my recipe that's really reliable for doing your very own salt beef. We're talking about the beautiful brisket of beef, right? This is the tail end of a brisket of beef. Still to this day, it should be a much cheaper cut from beef. Beef is always expensive, but the brisket is really good value. We need to cure that. Why would we cure it? Because we want to extend the shelf life. We want to make it last longer. So if you go back a few hundred years, of course we didn't have fridges and freezers. We had things like curing. So we use things like salt and sugar for, you know, controlling any bugs on here, right? But not only that, it gives an incredible flavor as well, a beautiful juiciness. So let's show you how to make a beautiful brine. Brine is a salty water, a salty flavored water. So here I've got 2 liters of water. I'm bringing it to the boil. Why are we boiling it? Because essentially we want to make kind of a savory tea, an infusion. So the first part of the infusion is lovely herbs. You can pick and choose any herb you love. It could be, you know, rosemary, it could be bay. I'm using thyme. So thyme goes into the water. Then I'm gonna go in with 3 cloves. This is quite powerful, right? But really perfumed and gorgeous. So in with the cloves. I've got 1 tablespoon of mustard seeds, which will give a fantastic mustardy flavor, which is delicious. And then gorgeous red peppercorns, 1 tablespoon. And then 1/2 tablespoon of the lovely little allspice here. So we're going to go in with that, and that's going to create the flavor. Secondly, the cure, the salting, right? So we've got 200 grams of salt going in here. So 200 grams of salt to 2 liters of water will give you the right salinity that will not only flavor that beef in the most beautiful way, but give you that kind of protection in the curing that you need. Now, not only that, we're going to use kind of two-tone curing, right? We're going to use sugar, 100 grams. So 1/2 the sugar to the salt. And then there's an optional curveball. And that is butcher's cure, right? 30 grams of butcher's cure. Now, why is this different? Yes, it is a salt, but it also has some other kind of nitrates in there that give you that pink color. So that's an optional ingredient that goes in. Bring that to the boil, then switch it off, let it cool down because we don't want to be putting hot things on raw things. And here's one I did earlier, right? So here's a cure that I've done. We want to use a nice little glass or plastic container to put our beautiful beef, because what will happen is the brine will react with the metal in the pan, and we don't want that. So put that into your container and then cover it with that amazing brine. Look at the color. Now, if you're going to double or quadruple this recipe, you don't actually have to double or quadruple the brine, right? The only rule with the brine, apart from those quantities, is make sure whatever meat you have is covered beautifully in this. So absolutely, if you had twice as much meat, you know, you'd still be able to cover it nice and easy. Now, to do its work, we need to help it a little bit. If you get like a skewer, a little knife, maybe a little carving fork, and just stab the meat all the way through, what's going to happen is that will allow that brine to penetrate all through the meat. Okay, so if it's floating, you can grab anything that will weigh it down and keep that meat submerged. So now we put that in the fridge for, wait for it, 5 days. 5 days. And this, of course, is why factories do it and restaurants do it. It doesn't happen so much in the home, but I promise you, you know, when you've cooked that and it's hot and juicy and tender and you're just carving it into a little sandwich, it's the best thing ever. So in the fridge we go, and then I'll show you what happens next. So look at this. It's had 5 days. This is one I've done, you know, earlier, obviously, but the texture and the color has changed. And now we're going to cook it. So look, what I want to do now is drain this salt beef from all of this liquid. Pour all that away. And then I want to fill this up with fresh water. So cover it with fresh water. Have a little look at that. And that will let the excess salt kind of leach out. And that's very typical for anything that's been salted or brined. Over here, I've got 1/2 a pan of water coming to the boil. And we're now going to poach this beautiful salt beef, okay? So in this water, we're going to use some typical sort of fragrant ingredients. Celery, carrots, couple of carrots, a couple of celery sticks, like that. Just chop them up like that. We've got some onions, just quarter those. A little bit of bay leaf, some peppercorns. So look, just put the veggies in there. You know, a little teaspoon of black peppercorns, and that is gonna be really tasty. In we go into the water. So get that beef in there, submerge it in the water. Right, I'm gonna get a lid, and we're gonna poach this nice and gently. Nice and gently for two and a half hours. So let that cook, and then I'll show you what to do next, because we've got some fun things to do. So the salt beef is cooked. It's had 2.5 hours, and I've literally just turned the heat off, and it's gonna stay nice and warm, okay? So now we're gonna fill it. It could be a sandwich. It could be a beautiful homemade bagel. But I wanna show you just how you can embellish a very simple mustard. So yes, we all buy mustards. We get them in the jars, but you might have seen the mustard powder in these little tins, the dried mustard powder. So this is an English mustard powder. So I'm gonna put a little bit of vinegar, white wine vinegar, into the mustard. I'm gonna add some seasoning of salt and pepper and some sugar, but you could use honey as well. Really, really nice. Have a little taste. Delicious, delicious. Is it worth it? Yes. Even if you took everyday little pickles like this, right? I love pickles, these little dill pickles. What I quite like to do sometimes is redress these, okay? So if I just take, let's say 3 or 4 for the moment, I can just slice these up at an angle like that, or you can use a little crinkle cutter if you've got one. So we're gonna dress these up, and you can use any lovely fresh herb. So I love using dill, but it could be parsley. You could even use things like basil if you wanted to. So in we go. So just take a nice bit of that herb and get that in there and embellish it, right? Even things like chilies. So red, green, yellow chilies, really thinly sliced. And you'll thinly slice them and they'll kind of pickle quite quickly. Look at that. So in we go. And I like, actually, to kiss it with a little olive oil. But it's almost like a little salad, look at that. So, flavor, 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 texture, you know, freshness, excitement, taking the everyday kind of good or dreary sandwich and taking it to a place that is just insanely good. So look, we've got dressed up pickles, homemade mustards, right? We've got homemade bagels. Come on, enough talking. Let's get filling, take it out. I like to put the meat on a board that's sitting on a tray to catch any of the juices so you don't get mess on the floor. Get a sharp carving knife and just slice nice thin slices all the way down the length of this beautiful cut of meat. Look at that. Look at the colour. I like to go nice and fine, but I want to generously fill the sandwich at the same time. So nice long strokes of the meat. Look at this. Look at the colour, guys. Look at the texture. Can you see how we've taken that tough cut of meat? We've made it beautifully tender. Then we're gonna take a bagel. These are homemade bagels. If you want the recipe for these beautiful bagels, then click the link somewhere. Cut the bagel. I like to butter it on both sides. I'm gonna kiss it with that amazing homemade mustard. I'm gonna go in with some pickles, and then we're gonna go in with our amazing salt beef. Look at that, guys. Woo-hoo! Buttered bagel on top. Hello, there you go. A hot filled salt beef bagel with dressed up pickles and homemade mustard. Happy blooming days. Let's get in there, let's cut it in half. I know you're not supposed to, but I wanna see what's going on in there. Look at this. Whoa. Woo! Look at that. Homemade salt beef. You've got to give this a try.